Namaste children, and welcome to today's session. Hope you're all fine and safe. Let us now go into the session. Now the same thing, we have a little bit of recalling. When just look at the screen, there is a quotation. When you have come to the edge of all the light you have and step into the darkness of the unknown, believe that one of the two will happen to you. Either you'll find something solid to stand on, or you'll be taught how to fly. So here, when you are in something unknown place, two things you will find. What are the things? That is, you'll find something very solid that is to follow, or you will be taught how to overcome that situation. Okay, so that is the meaning of this. So here today we'll be doing the recalling. Let us recall the first lesson and the poem. You'll be given some writing exercise for practice, and assessment will be conducted at the weekend. So listen carefully and take note of the exercises carefully. Now let us recall the lesson. His First Flight by Lyme O'Flaherty. So we are now going to see how a small seagull overcame its fear and took his first step to fly. I have a bit of the lesson here. We'll just read it out. The young seagull was alone on his ledge. His two brothers and his sister had already flown away the day before. He had been afraid to fly with them. So what was the problem of the seagull? It was afraid to fly. Even though his brothers and sisters had flown away, this seagull was very afraid. It did not have the courage to fly. So his brothers and sisters had flown away from the ledge. In spite of their encouragement, he hesitated to fly. He stood alone in the ledge, staring at the huge waves, and thought his wings will not support him. So even though the character of the bird is to fly, if it flaps its wings, it will be able to fly. It had the strength to fly, but it did not have the confidence that it could fly. So he was hungry, and his parents were adamant not to feed it until it flies and catches its own prey. He was hungry and cried out to his parents for food, but they turned a deaf ear to his calls. They wanted him to fly and catch his own food. He searched all over the ledge and found some eggshells in the nest. So there was nothing left over on the ledge. It had only some eggshells which was left over, and it began to eat that. After that, it did not satisfy his hunger. He was still hungry. So the mother thought of a plan. It tore a fish and began to fly towards her son. So the seagull, the young seagull, was very hesitant to fly. It did not have the courage to fly. So the mother thought of a plan, and she picked up a piece of fish, and as it was going to feed the child, it flew over to the ledge. The sight of food maddened him. So on seeing the food and on seeing his mother coming towards him, he became very happy, and he made a loud cackle and reached out for the food. His mother, but what happened? The mother was very clever. She did not give the food to the child. Instead, it stood a little far away from the edge of the ledge and wanted the child to jump and grab the food. So the seagull jumped, and as it was natural for the bird, it started to flap its wings. Unknowingly, it started to fly. So the moment the seagull felt his wings flapping in the air, he soared up and he had made his first flight. So you can see how the seagull made his first flight. So the seagull overcame its fear. He uttered a joyous scream and flapped them again. He soared higher. He raised his breast and banged against the wind. Gaga, gaga, golua. His mother swooped past him. So his mother encouraged him to fly by making the noise. Her wings making a loud noise. He answered her with another scream. Then his father flew over him screaming. Then he saw his two brothers and sisters flying around him, soaring and diving. So he was very happy. Unknowingly also, he began to fly. And he got the confidence that he could fly. So what did you understand? Here you can see that don't believe what your eyes are telling you. Whatever your eyes are telling you, it is only the limit. They show only the limitation. Look with your understanding. So understand the situation so that you can find new ways. Find out what you already know and you will see the way to fly. So here, the story of the seagull has taught us that just don't be in your limitations. Your strength is unlimited. So if you think that you can and you have the confidence that you can, you will be able to do anything and everything. Here, so you have a clear idea of the lesson, isn't it? Now we have some questions. Some 8 questions I've given here. So why did the seagull fail to fly? Why did the seagull fail to fly? Because it did not have the confidence and it believed that its wings were not strong enough so that he could fly. Then what did the parents do when the young seagull failed to fly? What happened? The parents, what did they do? Did they encourage or they just left him? Yes, so they encouraged him, isn't it? The parents encouraged the seagull to fly. And what was the first catch of the young seagull's older brother? It was a herring, the fish, which the older brother of the seagull caught, the first catch. So what did the young seagull manage to find in his search for food on the land? So what did it find? It found the shells of the eggs. Okay, the eggs which they had hatched and from which the seagulls had come out. So those shells were remaining there on the ledge, and that is what the young seagull managed to find. Then what did the young bird do to seek the attention of his parents? So what did, first it called out, isn't it? It shouted to attract the attention of its parents. Then after that, it pretended to be falling asleep near the ledge so that the parents would come and care for it. But the parents ignored him. Then what made the young seagull go mad? The sight of food. The mother seagull had taken a piece of fish and began to fly over to the young seagull. So that sight made the young seagull go mad. Why did the young bird utter a joyful scream? Why? Well, on seeing the food, isn't it? On seeing its mother coming towards him with food. And did the mother bird offer any food to the young bird? The mother offered or not? It offered but did not give it to the bird. the mother bird wanted to make the young bird fly, isn't it? Yes. So here again we have some more. That is, we have the memory poem, the first memory poem, isn't it? So this once again you have to memorize and write. I'll just read it out. Let me but live my life from year to year with forward face and unreluctant soul, not hurrying to, nor turning from the goal, not mourning for the things that disappear. In the dim past, nor holding back in fear from what the future veils, but with a whole and happy heart that pays its toll to youth and age and travels on with cheer. So let the way wind up the hill or down, over rough or smooth, the journey will be joy. Still seeking what I sought when but a boy. New friendship, high adventure, and a crown. My heart will keep the courage of the quest and hope the road's last turn will be the best. So last time when I took the poem, I had put it into a tune. Hope you remember it. You can, it's according to your way of understanding. If you can put it in a tune and sing, it's well and good. Or you can just memorize it as it is. So the poet is Henry Van Dyke. This is a memory poem, the first poem. And this will be assessed. Okay. So you'll be having assessment in the end of the week. So that's all for today. Now, what else you have to do is, you have to learn the short answers as well as the memory poem. And at the end of the, week, you'll be having an assessment of one word. I'll give you the questionnaire. That is for the first unit. Okay, for the first unit, we'll be having an assessment because we have not done any assessment. So you'll have for about 50 marks, you'll be having an assessment using the first unit. So in the next class, we'll be revising the supplementary and some of the exercises. Okay, vocabulary and grammar exercises will be revised in the next session. Okay, thank you for listening and take notes. Write down the short answers and the memory poem and go through the book back exercises also, vocabulary as well as the synonyms, antonyms. Then you'll have the grammar exercises also. Okay, so just go through the exercises. The composition I had taken. So the first three exercises of composition, that is advertisement, report writing, and dialogue writing and all with them, isn't it? So just go through those also. So you'll have an assessment at the end of this week. Okay. So thank you, and that's all for now. We'll meet you in the next class.